Hello everyone, welcome to our webinar. We are going to present you our main power transmission and motion control valve functions and how we combine them in customized solutions that bring many benefits to our customers, from increased performance to space saving. My name is Aleš Novák, I'm a product portfolio manager for power transmission and motion control valves at POCLAIN HYDRAULICS.
And my name is Johan Brunel, I am control system engineer at POCLAIN HYDRAULICS.
The webinar will be split in some parts. The main functions and valves for power transmission solutions and their combined solutions. In this part, my colleague Jon will explain also our traction control solutions. The second part will be dedicated to motion control valves and their combined solutions. The third part, we will explain the benefits of combo and multifunction valves. Let's start first with the power transmission part. This webinar is dedicated to valves, but especially when we are designing valves, it's very important to know the complete system. Valves are here to control the control part that are connecting the motors and the pumps into a complete functional system solution. The main power transmission functions are traction control, freewheeling for eddy drive or on-demand transmission for additional traction, then exchange or flushing valves. We have directional control valves, then protection valves, and finally piloting functions for speed shifting and brake control. We are going to explain some of them more in details. For the traction control, we have several ways to ensure that the wheels have grip with the ground, even in rough conditions. From traction lock with flow dividers to more sophisticated electronically controlled proportional VMA valves. I'll let Johan explain this more in details.
Thank you, Aleš. Let's start with the most basic solutions based on hydraulically regulated flow. These valves are acting as differential locking system in a hydrostatic transmission to prevent from skidding of the wheels. Concretely, the valve can be seen as a T-junction where the difference of flow between A and B port is sensed and the valve is acting to keep it under control. According to machine topology and type of terrain, by choosing the appropriate split ratio and appropriate position of the valve in the circuit, it is possible to control the skidding between front and rear axle or between left and right wheel. You can find in this slide the most complex option with full traction control, but many other arrangements are possible. In addition, transfer orifice can be used to ease steering, a kind of limited slip differential effect. And finally, when high turning radius is expected, high speed is needed, or if the situation just doesn't require it because adherence is good, the driver can switch to bypass mode, which results in a very low power loss through the valve. So if you want something robust, capable to handle up to 500 bar, 300 liters per minute in bypass mode, and without complex electronic, then this is a very good solution for you.
In fact, we have medium duty range, it is called FDM, it goes up to 420 bar, and heavy duty range, we call it FDH, up to 500 bar to fit our customer needs.
Thank you, Aleš, for this clarification, you're right. Okay, so jumping now to electronic solution through VMA valve. In this case, an ECU is controlling the valves and sensors are added, such as wheel speed sensors and steering sensor. Based on that architecture, a control algorithm is comparing the speed of each wheel and act to keep speed differences below a given limit by reducing the throttle area of the valve that feed the motor connected to the skidding wheel.
Johan, what does this solution bring to our customers?
I would say flexibility, optimal performance, comfort of usage, and minimized power consumption. So why flexibility? Because we can adapt the solution to any machine just through a software calibration. Why optimal performance? Because the control can be adapted to the ground topology and the vehicle speed in order to act preventively and thus be more reactive, and because traction control can be fully operational even in steering situations. And then why minimize power consumption? Because the valve is acting automatically only when needed, with reduced pressure drop when no skidding situation is detected. And finally, the comfort of usage, because driver can just avoid it. Activation is fully automatic. On top of that, all hydraulic lines protection, overpressure or cavitation are included. And finally, the valve is compatible with heavy duty system up to 450 bar and fully integrated in POCLAIN City Suite embedded software solution.
Thank you, Johan, for this detailed presentation. Let's continue now with freewheeling valves. We use freewheeling valves called VDF valves when we want to engage and disengage POCLAIN in-wheel motors. It is an on-demand additional traction system called eddy drive. We engage motors for off-road mode or working mode, and we disengage motors when we need more speed, like on-road. Basically, they retract the pistons inside the cylinder block of the motor, preventing them to contact a cam ring at high speed, leading to almost no drag torque in the wheel and thus very low power losses. In such a way, we freewheel the motors. VDA valves can be used in full hydraulic transmission, like for instance combine harvesters, or in hybrid transmissions, like used for instance in motor graders. Hybrid in this case, it means mechanical drive plus hydraulic drive in front wheels for additional traction. Another typical case is eddy drive system for trucks and trailers. Engagement or disengagement can be done on the fly, it means when the machine is moving, or on static machine. Selector or diverter valves are used in open loop and closed loop circuits. In closed loop circuits, these are used to select between two motors that do not operate simultaneously. For instance, to divert the flow between the driving wheels or tracks and the tools. Typical application for that is horizontal directional drill, where a selector valve is diverting the flow between the track drive and the tool drive. The tool drive, it means drilling tools, push-pull and drill rotate. It's very important to keep low pressure drop through those valves, as the flow is always passing through them. We pay particular attention to this, optimizing channeling through fluid dynamics, CFD calculations. Let me mention another interesting functions of these valves with the use of dedicated spool in the valve. They can switch between series and parallel motor connection, allowing having two different motor connections on the same machine. This also is another solution to shift speeds, and in case of two-speed motors, you can reach 1-to-4 ratio in work and travel speed. Again, on horizontal drilling machines, they allow slow speed when drilling and very high speed when returning to insert another drilling rod. VDF circuit isolation valves allow opening and closing a circuit to redirect the circuit to bypass an axle or to unify two circuits together. KVHP stands for high pressure directional control valves, as they are used in transmissions, so above the classical 350 bar pressure that is usual for such directional control valves. They change the turning direction of a wheel to allow sideways drive of, for instance, forklift trucks, or they allow zero turning radius of autonomous vehicles. While KVC valves are used for piloting functions such as park brake control and displacement shifting of the motors. Series protection valves. They connect motors in serial line and provide protection of the motors against cavitation and overpressure. These are widely used on smaller machines where the motors are connected in series. We also provide protection valves dedicated to industrial applications, for instance, typically our shredders. Crossover relief and anti-cavitation valves are designed to be flanged on our industrial range of motors. These are MHP motors, large MS motors, and MI, called motor industrial. Exchange or flushing valves bleed hot oil from the low pressure side of a hydrostatic transmission circuit to be cooled, filtered, or used as a source of oil for flushing pump or motor cases. Standard offer of flushing valves ranges from V10, V30, V60 according to the flow rate. We have designed V30 and V60 flushing valves to be optionally flanged on a valve blocks, and VES60 additionally includes high pressure relief valves. Pressure reducers. They limit the pressure in motor brake line in auxiliary functions line, meaning they reduce the pressure from high pressure to low pressure, used for piloting functions. This is to the level of charge pressure. They're used mainly on applications with brake line control for radial motors or any other inline pressure reducer. Basically, all those functions that we explained, we also combine in so-called combo valves. With these combinations, we offer the most technically optimized solution with minimized losses. Single valve solution instead of several valves piped together by hoses. Solutions are adapted to customer's machine with the right orientation of the ports small size and low weight. Cost-effective solutions that save space and cost of piping. And finally, they allow customer to build a clean machine with not too many components. The main and most typical functions for which we already have existing designs are freewheeling to engage and disengage the hydraulic motors, traction control with medium duty or heavy duty flow divider, flushing and piloting for speed shifting and park brake control. And of course, other functions can be added upon request. Combo valves are designed for medium duty applications. It goes up to maximum 420 bar. Typical applications are forklift trucks, and heavy duty applications up to maximum 500 bar. Typical applications are motor graders or harvesters. They can be designed for standalone mount or even to be integrated or flanged on our motors or pumps, but later about that in the presentation. Let us continue now with motion control functions used for mainly tools controls. The main functions here are directional control valves, including diverter or selector valves, flow control valves, and finally pressure control valves, including load holding valves. Selector or diverter valves are used to select between two hydraulic motors or cylinders when these are not working at the same time. They are very useful for additional function of a tool, as you don't need another proportional control valve. You rather divert the flow from existing control valve to additional function. You can imagine many attachments from construction to agriculture machines that need such functions, and this is also the reason that POCLAIN HYDRAULICS is very famous for a wide range of selector valves. Sizes go from 6, 8, 10, 16, so up to above 400 liter per minute. They can be standalone, modular, flanged, or combined with any other functions, like for instance flow divider. We also have wide range of setup 3 and setup 5 valves with corresponding modular valves. This is very wide range of usage of these valves from mobile to industrial applications. In open loop applications, such are for instance winches or vertical drilling machines, we need load holding valves or so-called counterbalance valves. They're designed to create back pressure at the return line of the actuator, can be motor or cylinder, to prevent losing control over the load. Regarding the level of integration, we can have standalone valves. When possible, we integrate them on motors or pumps, and some solutions are even integrated in the motors or pump. The two typical cases of integration on the motors are swing drive valves and vertical drilling valves. Both are open loop applications. VMR valves are solutions for swing drive for excavators. Functions added on the MS motors are crossover relief, shockless, anti-cavitation, anti-rebound, and automatic brake release. Shockless valves provide smoother operation and better feeling of the operator. Moreover, with the two-step relief valve solution, we can have different settings for accelerating and decelerating, and the setting can be even piloted, so the set is based on pilot signal. Another motion control solution are BMO blocks for open loop applications. Typically, there will be vertical drilling machines and winches. There we combine load holding or counterbalance, anti-cavitation, pressure reducing, piloting, and other functions that are flanged on our radial piston motors. Let us continue now with the third part to explain all benefits of combo and multifunction valves. Combo valves bring many benefits to our customers. Less hydraulic losses due to less fittings and piping and the customized design itself. Less needed space on the machine. Beside that, the machine looks much cleaner. They decrease cost associated with the elimination of piping, hoses, and other components like our fixation elements. They bring lower risk of leakages due to less components. They are also easy and quick to install. Ports positioning, fixation, dimension, and surface protection are adapted to the needs of the machine. And finally, they increase safety with fewer hoses under high pressure. In the end, we show you one case of multifunction block for a marine winch. combining freewheeling, load holding, back pressure and piloting functions. You can see the difference between the prototype where we were testing the concept and the serial solution integrated on the motor with almost the same features. The difference is obvious. That would be all from our side. Johan, maybe we have missed something?
Yes, I have one question, Aleš. What is the right quantity to design a combo valve or a multifunction valve?
Okay, it's a good and a kind of expected question, but it's not very easy to give a definite number on that. We have all basic functions developed. We only need to combine them in a dedicated solution. Basically, it means designing a new housing. In that regards, we could say we target more than about 100 valves per year with a certain minimum order quantity. Moreover, some solutions already exist. So for instance, valve combining freewheeling functions, two-way medium duty flow divider for traction control, flushing valve and pilot valve for brakes or speed shifting. Here the quantity can be even lower. I hope such answer gives an idea about the target quantity.
Yeah, I think it's really clear, and thank you very much for this. We also have another question from customer. They are asking if we produce cartridge valves. What do you answer?
Cartridge valves, yes, we produce cartridge valves. All basic functions explained are designed by us, and almost all are also produced by us. But we don't sell all these functions as standalone valves. For instance, dividing cartridge for traction control is our product. Mm-hmm. But it is sold only in medium-duty flow dividers, FDM, DTP, and heavy-duty flow dividers. The same goes for flushing cartridges that are sold as VA valves or integrated in motors and pumps. Okay, thank you very much for your attention, and you can always reach us through the following contacts or through the web form on our webpage. Thank you and have a good day.
Thank you all. Bye.